Rwanda, says Kuczynski, is a small country, so small that on certain maps of Africa, it is marked with only a dot. You must read the accompanying explanatory notes to discover that this dot at the continent's very center indicates Rwanda. It is a mountainous country. Plains and plateaus are more characteristic of Africa, whereas Rwanda is mountains and low mountains. They rise 2,000, 3,000 meters, even higher. That is why Rwanda is frequently called the Tibet of Africa. Although it earned this moniker not only because of its mountains, but also on account of its singularity, distinctness, difference. It is worth mentioning some specificity of the genocide committed in Rwanda. One of them was the failure of the international community to prevent it, in spite of abundant and credible information on its imminence. This failure is more particularly great of the UN and its most influential member states, as is their responsibility with inappropriate decision to call back almost the entire contingent of the United Nations Assistance Mission to Rwanda, UNAMIM, only a few days after the beginning of the genocide. This an understandable decision taken by the Security Council on April 21st, 1994, enlarged the already existing gap between the community of the genocide victims on the one hand and the international community on the other hand. Indeed, time has passed since a very important Vienna World Conference on Human Rights in 1993, where a kind of north-south divide had appeared along the issue of the universality of human rights. In those years, some political actors and theoreticians from the Southern Hemisphere had promoted the view that the development had to take place first for human rights to be foreseeable. Since the year 1990, the gap between the concepts of development and human rights has been progressively narrowing. While was emerging and being strengthened, the ideas that development has to do with people and that its measurement must reflect how much it has actually enlarged people's choices. On the other hand, Southern peoples, namely on the African continent, have demonstrated in practice the way they value democracy and human rights through the passionate own mobilizations, for instance, against apartheid in South Africa and its destabilizing effects on neighboring countries. As a result of this evolution, it is now possible to state that the existence of a tight and reciprocal relationship between human rights and development is well established, as well as the relationship between democracy and economic growth in Southern Hemisphere countries, without risking automatic political excommunication. Indeed, if we consider the African continent, for instance, progress in matters of good governance, democracy and political participation, human rights, civic education are now part and parcel of all national constitutions and all stated national political programs, as well as all sub-regional and regional organization manifestos. One would be a question related to what should be the international community, what should be the action of the international community to avoid future tragedies like the genocide in Rwanda. Another question is the following. forming, it really, the United Nations and other important regional organizations, drew all necessary lessons from those tragedies. In other words, are we better prepared to prevent or eventually confront such changes in if they arise again in the future? These and others are some of the issues on which I think that we should exchange ideas during the expert discussions. However, I am sure that many of them could also valuably inspire academic research by some eminent academicians present here and tomorrow of some students present here. The reason why I already feel hope, satisfaction, and gratitude for having shared with you the little things that I have learned through my own intellectual work and above all through my life experience, I thank you for your attention.